For all the good things we can say about those Seahawks, to say that their running game is anemic would almost be too nice.
Wait, time out.
Okay.
Because we do this show for Twitter. That's okay. Why we do the show. So last week when we left the show, Seattle Seahawks fans were mad, Jeffrey.
Yes, they were.
They were mad at both you and I.
Yes, they were.
And here's
why.
We were cool, right?
We
were cool.
Y'all were cool. This is why they were mad, Jeff.
Yes.
Oh, we're physical.
Yes.
Oh, we can run the ball. Why are you pointing to old trades?
Right.
Seattle had 33 yards rushing.
Oh.
33.
Ryan, the defense still the same?
Yeah. That is an anemic rushing game.
I don't know where my camera at. Hey, I know we about to enter November, but July. Because you don't.
Yes.
You saw the same things we were talking about last week that they needed to work on, which was running the football, which was stopping the big plays defensively. You saw those things rear their ugly heads again. But we also saw what we've seen from Russell Wilson week after week after week. Under pressure, creating plays, getting the ball downfield, and finding ways to win. And it's what he's done his whole career.
Yep.
But usually it's because the defense is also keeping people out of the end zone.
That's right.
He's a guy who's moving into the MVP conversation for how much he is carrying this offense and team.
It is definitely on his back. I mean, I think we talked about it. They had 1 yard rushing. I think at the end, towards the end of the third quarter, they had 1 yard. And we looked at it, and it's insane that you're asking Russell Wilson to do that much with this football team week in and week out. And by the way, pass protection isn't at a premium either. So it's not like he's just running free, sitting in a pocket all day. I mean, this guy is moving around.
Balling, bro.
I mean, playing out of his mind. Both guys played awesome. You hate to see anybody lose, but I can tell you, neither team thought they were going to have 41 or 38. Right.